biggest thing for us has been housing. Housing, we have been stuck in a flat on the third, on the ninth floor of a high rise for 3.5 years, until April this year, when we were finally moved. But there wasn't much scope for moving into wheelchair accessible housing. We find that to be the biggest problem. For us, living in the UK, I think sometimes, regardless of what's happening in Europe, I feel like our government seems to be blocking progress regardless. It's been a really good opportunity for us. It's been a really exciting experience. We have flown for the first time. We have been on holiday abroad for the first time. And it's something that, it's actually opened my eyes, because it's not as difficult as I was expecting it to be. And I know a lot of the work was done for us, but the actual process of coming here has been really, really rewarding. And it means that we might consider, in the future, you know, going a bit further afield rather than staying in Scotland. The conference itself has been fascinating. I found it to be really enriching. Hearing other people's experiences, in one way, is really good for just opening your eyes to other people's situations, and to, I suppose, just thinking of things that you haven't necessarily thought of, seeing things from a different perspective, and also for appreciating what we do have, because there's a lot of people in much worse situations than we're in, and I think it's good sometimes to reflect on what you do have, as well as just fighting for what you don't. Our experience with healthcare has been really good and really positive, and the National Health Service in Scotland has been invaluable, really. I don't quite know what I would do without it. It's very well organised for Spina Bifida in particular, and our consultants and the people that we work with have all been really helpful and accommodating, and I suppose just we're treated as a family. Like, it's not just Baxter that's treated, we're all treated together, and it really does make a big difference. I haven't actually thought that far ahead yet, but I'm hoping that it's a smooth process. I'm hoping that by the time he's an adult, which is another 15 years away, I'm hoping that by that time everything's just much more fluid, I suppose. Because I think things are changing. I think attitudes are changing. I think I don't think it's as difficult as it used to be. I think it could help in some ways, but I also think it could hinder in other ways. Because I think sometimes if you make too many rules and too many laws, then you'll end up making a certain section of society quite scary for other people. You see you come in, and I think it kind of labels people sometimes, which I don't think is helpful. But in other ways, then, yes, I suppose it would be helpful, because there are lots of situations where there is discrimination. And I think in the wider world, definitely. For us, it hasn't been in the healthcare system at all, but I have... Every three months, we have a clinic that meets, where we meet all his specialists in the same afternoon, and it makes it easier for us, because we don't have to have, you know, 3, 4, 5, 6 different appointments. We just spend one afternoon, and all the families in the area who also have spina bifida, they're at the clinics as well. So it's, you know, it's a social thing as well as a medical thing.